For supper one night, in the dim lantern light, I made cream of celery soup. There were small appetites that particular night, not exactly a ravenous group. I poured leftovers ample in a jug of enamel, but my fridge was already full, so out on the porch was a table of sorts where the overflow food kept cool. Well chilled it remained in the wind and the rain, in temperatures close to freezing. You know, it took lots of food to feed the big crew that hired on in roundup season. Well, a couple nights passed. Then I planned a light snack, sandwiches and leftover soup. I sliced the bread and retrieved the jug from the broken-down cookhouse stoop. I set the soup half-froze at the side of the stove where the fire threw a gentler heat, and there I drew near for the occasional stir whilst in between slicing the meat. As I gave it a turn so it wouldn't burn, I thought a dark shadow slid by. But with the lanterns we had, the lighting was bad, so I wasn't sure what caught my eye. Back to the bread. The butter was spread, then mustard and meat was applied. I gave the soup one more whirl, and again in the swirl that mysterious shadow I spied. I grabbed the soup ladle where it lay on the table, and with it I gave a deep scoop. After several attempts, I nearly quit in contempt. There was nothing but celery soup. Sore tempted was I to let it pass by as poor lighting and a good imagination, when one final dip brought a hand to my lip with an involuntary exclamation. It was a little drowned mouse! Ah! And as my shriek shook the house, the events of his death, I surmised. He fell from the rim, in my soup had a swim, till exhausted, he met his demise. Curled up in the sauce with his nose on his paws, fleeting sadness I could not help but feel. If creamed soup was his favorite, perhaps he had savored it. I hoped he'd enjoyed his last meal. Then I threw the little man in the garbage can and turned back to my duties. Now what was the scoop with my celery soup? For sure it was plumb full of cooties. It was time for the gong, but things had gone wrong. Now what was I going to serve? I could stick with plan A, serve the soup anyway. But did I really have the nerve? The slop pail beckoned. Still I wavered and reckoned, 'cause with saving food, I'm a miser. I could boil that jug to kill any bugs and no one would be the wiser. To throw it away would ruin my day. When it comes to wasting, I hate to. But propriety prevailed. I dumped the soup in the pail and opened some Campbell's tomato.